This is your gut, full of tons of friendly faces that make up your gut microbiome. The over 100 trillion microbial cells do a whole lot more than just sit and look cute for the pictures, though. They have a profound impact on your brain chemistry. So you might be wondering, what does this slimy tract really have to do with your brain? I mean, surely the place that you poop out of can't be connected to our complex cognitive hub. But the gut-brain connection, or the gut-brain axis, as scientists like to call it, is a strong link that connects our gut to how we think and how we feel. The gut-brain connection isn't just a line that we can draw up from our stomach to our brains. It's a web of sorts, made up of multiple systems within the body. But today, we're just going to be focusing on those little microbial friends that we met earlier. They're constantly producing chemicals. And for a really long time, we thought these chemicals were just used in the gut alone. But recent research has shown us that they actually impact the levels of neurotransmitters in our brain. So, for the non-neuron enthusiasts in the audience, neurotransmitters carry signals across our brain to exert an action. And their dysregulation has been associated with mood disorders like depressive disorder, as well as neurological disorders such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. So now that we have a little bit of context, let's think back to our little microbial friends that are pumping out some pretty big chemicals. They're making some pretty big names like serotonin, dopamine, and glutamate. Serotonin is associated with boosted mood, and its dysregulation has been linked to things like depressive disorders, whereas glutamate is associated with stress regulation and control. And dopamine plays an important role in your reward system, and so it's linked to satiety and pleasure. Its dysregulation has been linked to neurological disorders like Parkinson's and schizophrenia. So we now know that one, our gut microbe influences our neurotransmitters, and two, these neurotransmitters are associated with our mental health and our cognition. So let's put those two together, shall we? Well, in studies in germ-free rats, when they lack a gut microbiota, show us that there are changes in anxiety-like behaviors that occur. Additionally, genes that correlate with brain structures like the amygdala and the hippocampus that are associated with emotion control and regulation also change. We also know that when we take specific pathogen-free rats as well, they exacerbate responses to stress when the microbiota is dysregulated. So it's through research like this that we can tell that a diverse and regulated microbiota impacts our brain and our behavior. But here's where it gets really interesting. Your gut microbiome isn't static. In fact, it changes with environmental demands, like what you eat. High fat diets have been associated with changes in neurotransmitter levels, which affects the health of our brain. So while research is still investigating some more specific links between individual neurotransmitters like serotonin and dopamine and specific foods we can eat, we do know that there are some ways that we can help our overall health of our gut microbiome. Prebiotic fibers feed those friendly little faces, and they're found in things like whole grains, fruits, and vegetables. Probiotics, which are found in foods that contain live bacteria cultures, such as fermented foods like yogurts or pickled vegetables like kimchi or sauerkraut, also help our overall health of our gut microbiome. In fact, in a 2011 study by a team of researchers, we see that probiotic ingestion actually decreases anxiety-like and depressive-like symptoms, and the ingestion of probiotics can reverse pre-existing anxiety-like behaviors. So while I can't tell you that eating a specific food will cure your depression, I can tell you that research is currently looking at more specific links between neurotransmitters like dopamine and serotonin and the foods that we can be eating. In fact, psychiatrists are even looking at treating our guts as a means of treating mental health disorders in a way we've never been able to before. In people and patients that are resistant to current treatment methods like antidepressants. So what can you take away from all of this? Well, firstly, there's a second brain down here that directly affects the brain up here. And secondly, we can change the chemistry of the gut and impact the levels of neurotransmitters it produces. While this field is much newer and still being researched, we know that there are ways that we can generally support the health of our gut microbiome through ingestion of prebiotics and probiotics. It is through fields like these that we can see just how much of an impact our everyday behavior can have on our mental and physical well-being. Given the nature of mental health disorders is pervasive within our school community, but within our global community as well, my question to you all today here is why not? I'm making no promises that swapping out the crisps for some whole grain fibers is going to solve all of your anxiety, but I am telling you that it's one of the actionable changes that you can take to take back control over your mental and physical well-being. So why not eat away the anxiety? Thank you.